Now, if you've ever shopped for a gaming monitor, then you've definitely seen those words, response time. But what does it all really mean though? What is GTG, BTW, MPRT, and does it all really matter to you? Will it make you a less shitty of a gamer? Well, technically. When it comes to monitors, depending on what kind of user you are, you should prioritize different specifications. For gamers, other than resolution and refresh rate, you should also pay attention to a little thing called response time. Not to be confused with input lag, which is essentially how long it takes for your monitor to react to any action that you perform. Response time is measured in milliseconds, and depending on what kind of panel you have, it's gonna be ranging from 0.5ms to maybe 5ms. TN panels are the fastest, followed by VA and then IPS. In a standard 60Hz refresh rate monitor, a frame stays on the screen for just under 17 milliseconds, but the individual pixels need to transition much faster than that so that there's no delay in showing the next frame. So why should you care? Well, it all boils down to one word: ghosting. Ghosting is basically the blur trailing behind objects during fast scenes. It could be a car chase in a movie, or if you're jumping around in Shadow of the Tomb Raider, or being a complete badass in God of War. It is extremely distracting, especially when you're playing fast-paced first-person shooters like CSGO. You wanna be headshotting players, not ghosts. And now that I have your attention, let's take a closer look at response time. So what the flying roti canai is response time? Well, when you first turn on a monitor, it usually shows a black screen when nothing is being played. Record the time it takes for your monitor in this state to show one single white pixel, and you're gonna get the black to white response time. Similarly, if you measure the time it takes for one gray pixel on your monitor to transition to another shade of gray, then you're gonna get the gray to gray or GTG response time. So in summary, the response time rating is how quickly your monitor can change its pixels from gray to gray or black to white. So now that we've cleared that up, I'll see you in the next. Just kidding. There's more to this. So wait a minute, why do we need both black to white and gray to gray response time? Why can't we just settle on one? Well, it's all because of money, money, money. Manufacturers have figured out a long time ago that BTW is a lot slower than GTG response time. By advertising GTG to you, you're gonna get a much faster number and it's gonna be more appealing to consumers like you. That's why you should be listening to me to get informed. These days, since BTW response time is a lot less advertised, other than GTG, you will also see MPRT, which stands for Moving Picture Response Time. So firstly, gray to gray response time, contrary to its name, actually represents how fast your monitor can change its pixels between two colors. So why is it not called color to color or red to blue response time or something like that? Just hear me out. So LCD subpixels are actually all monochrome, and the colors that you see are achieved via color filters. The darker the gray, and the less light will penetrate the filter to get to your eyes, hence you're gonna see less intense colors, and vice versa. Measure the time it takes for a gray pixel on your monitor to transition to a different shade of gray, and you'll know how quickly it changes colors. Then again, there's no standardized test for this, which is why some monitors rated at 0.5ms has more ghosting than those rated at 2ms. I'm looking at you, shady manufacturers. Yang kedua nya, we have MPRT or Moving Picture Response Time, which is completely different to GTG or BTW response time. While GTG refers to pixel transition time, MPRT measures the pixel visibility time, which is why the higher the MPRT, the more motion blur you are going to notice. Theoretically, it is actually very easy to measure the MPRT response time of your monitor because it's all based on the refresh rate. A 60Hz refresh rate monitor is going to have an MPRT rating of 1/60th of a second. And if you have a monitor that is 144Hz refresh rate, then you're gonna get a 144th. 144th. What? Yeah, you know what I mean. Basically, the higher your refresh rate, the faster your MPRT response time. Don't trust me? go and try out a 240Hz monitor and see if it has less motion blur than your 60Hz Rakyat Mahin monitor lah. Of course, that is not the full picture, because manufacturers have figured out a very clever way to further reduce the MPRT response time with strobing backlights. What they actually do is synchronize the backlight with the refresh rate. So before showing a new frame, they're gonna turn off the backlight completely, which removes all traces of previous frames that are still clinging onto the screen. Cleverly. And that is precisely why you're gonna see a lot of monitors being advertised with a 1ms or 0.5ms MPRT response time. So in conclusion, these two methods of measuring response time is actually pretty confusing, because even though a pixel has completed its GtG transition from one color to another, it can still stay visible until the next refresh cycle. Which is why you should always take the advertised response time on spec sheets with a grain of salt, or 10. Or 100, you know what I mean. So what do you think? Should there be standardized tests for GtG response time, or should manufacturers just advertise both MPRT and GtG response time? So if you thought this video was helpful, or if you're uncle, brother, cousin, brother, or trying to buy a monitor, just like and share this video so they can see it. And don't forget to follow us on Facebook or subscribe to our YouTube channel to see more content like this. And I'll see you in the next one.